Most investors, whether new to the market or seasoned, have at least once heard their fund manager, a market expert, or their financial advisor advocate the importance of investing in quality stocks. But as investors, the very next question that we ask is, how do you find such quality stocks, and what is the meaning behind quality investing? Well, in this video, let us understand the importance and the meaning behind quality investing. Quality investing aims to identify opportunities in profit-making and cash-generating businesses. In simple terms, quality investing aims to find the best companies. Although there is no real rock-solid description of what quality stocks or what quality investment avenues are, we can still take a look at some measures. Take a look at this chart given here. What you can clearly see here is that the S&P BSE Quality Index has outperformed the S&P BSE Sensex, the S&P BSE 100, and even the S&P BSE 500. Not just that, you can also see that FPIs, or foreign portfolio investors, are heavily invested in the stocks of S&P BSE Quality Index. Let us now take a look at some scenarios where quality stocks held their ground even when there was turbulence in the market. The first example is of the commodity complex. Now, commodities as a business are cyclical. This means that the demand for commodities come with the economic growth or the appetite of global economies. And economic growth thereby, it becomes a good indicator to track commodities. Now, from 2013 to 2016, the commodity prices fell by almost 60% worldwide. This, however, was very positive for India because India is a net importer of commodities. But a few industries like steel, crude oil, and wheat bore the brunt of this fall because their balance sheets were deteriorated, and this caused a downfall in those stocks, destroying significant market wealth. The next example we are going to take a look at is the NPA cycle. The public sector banks have seen a significant decay in their asset quality since 2015. And as the NPA cycle grew worse, the banks had to provision, and that provisioning ate into their corporate profits, and thereby the asset qualities started deteriorating even more. And so these banks had to see a big fall in their share prices as well. And the same thing also happened with large corporate private banks as well. But for the retail-based private banks, this wasn't the case. They were largely unscathed and they came out strong during this whole period. And therefore, they commanded higher premiums in the market as well. Another pocket of quality lay in the housing finance and in the non-banking financial institutions as well, because they were also largely retail-focused and had strict ALM policies, which are asset liability management policies. And this kept them in check, and therefore, even they commanded higher premiums during this entire scenario. Now, let's take a look at the way forward. As highlighted previously in the video, the quality investing parameters have been historically proven to be all-weather wealth creators for investors in the long term. But the main question to ask is that what are the factors that are required to find and select quality stocks for your portfolio? These factors can be divided into two different parts. The first part are the quantitative factors, and the part two are the qualitative factors. Now, under quantitative factors, the first factor is the presence of strong and high growth metrics. This includes your return on capital employed and your return on equity as well. The second point is good and stable cash flow. Now, this is an important point because if any business wants to expand their businesses and fund their future programs and plans, they need to use their cash efficiently and thereby have a good cash flow. The third thing that you need to note in the quantitative factors are high return ratios, low debt to equity and consistent earnings. Now, let's take a look at the qualitative factors. The first qualitative factor that you need to take a look is the presence of good and professional management. The second factor you need to note is the presence of transparency in their operations. The third qualitative factor that you need to note is the credibility of the oversight committee and auditors. The final factor on the qualitative side is the presence of a long-term business model. And this style offers two potential advantages to all the investors. The first advantage is, like we discussed, quality investing presents the investors an opportunity to beat the broad-based indices over a long period of time. The second advantage is that quality stocks generally are not volatile in relative terms compared to the other market participants. And this is mostly due to the inherent fundamental qualities that these companies have. At Axis Mutual Fund, we follow a bottom-up stock selection criteria with a 2-3 year view on these stocks. And we are biased towards the high quality and strong fundamentally fit stocks. And these are the four principles that we strongly adhere to at Axis Mutual Fund as a part of our investment philosophy. The first principle we follow is following strong management and strong pedigree and experience of the professionals in the company. The second principle we follow is that the sector itself should be growing at least 1.5x or 2x of the GDP growth rate. The third principle that we follow is that we like to invest in companies with strong business models that demonstrate their pricing power in their product category. And finally, the fourth principle to follow is to take a look at the return on equities and have good cash flows. About 80 to 90% of our portfolio stocks are based on the principles of this philosophy, and we have been sticking to this philosophy since our inception in the year 2009. So overall, basically, investors have a great potential to earn returns on their investments if they go through the route of quality investing, which means they have to select good and fundamentally fit stocks. Now, to do that, you have to spend some time to do the research and you have to put some effort as well. Now, in case you don't have the time or you don't want to put the effort in the research, the mutual fund route is the best way to go ahead and get those potential returns. Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.